So, you must be wondering what this lady is going to talk about security. So let me start from where this all started for me. I have been working, this is like way back in 2000, when I was working with a multinational company, and then we were releasing a product which had an $100 million revenue at that time. Interesting, we had just shipped the product, and after a lot of late nights, had great fun, shipped. We just settled down and we were still partying, in fact. And then one of our customers called up and said there was a nasty bug. Nasty bug was bad during those days because that was the pre-cloud era. We used to ship products in CDs, burn them into CDs, put them into red boxes and ship them out. Now that, I was in the San Jose office where we had hundreds of boxes returning back because of one nasty bug that we had left into the code. And it was almost a humiliating experience to sit as an architect and see hundreds of boxes getting returned from channel partners, from our distribution specialists, from our vendors, just because there was one single security bug. That's where I started being a little more passionate about fixing bugs, fixing security bugs, trying to find it, fix it much earlier than where it started. By the way, that bug was a fairly simple one. It was in some random error condition that we were throwing up the admin password in clear text, which was not so great, but yeah, but it was nasty beyond words because we had to recall CDs during those days. So that's where I've been almost a decade or more, primarily around security reviews. I'm an ethical hacker, been around security for a long time, but that's what got me started really. Okay, so let me just get started with why would any of us move into a house that does not have doors or windows? We won't. We need all the doors done, all the windows done, all the last latch, all the last lock done. Before that, we wouldn't enter into the house. Forget occupying it. Even if there is one bolt that's missing, we'll say, no, this has to be fixed. That's where all of us are, right? But reality is here. 60% of code that's there on the bed, that's alive today, is almost like a house without a door or a window. Why? The house is actually open to vulnerabilities around the neighborhood. You can have only burglars around your neighborhood come and attack your house, pretty much. There is nobody else who will come. But code that is on the web is pretty much open to the entire world. But then we take the